I'll call this meeting to order. Roll call.
Art McLeary.
Here.
Larry Watson.
Here.
Billy Cloud.
Here.
Exeter Rules calls this meeting to order. Roll call.
Joe Clement.
Yeah.
Jerry Terrell.
Here.
Stoney Oaken.
Here. Item one, approve page of the legal.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Item number four is recognized guests. We want to thank all of our guests for being here today. Item number five, new business. Jim Dunn, you got anything, Larry?
No.
Sheriff, you got any new business today?
Not yet.
Brian? Tina? Sean? All right. You want to do your new business?
Exeter Board, number three, new business. Any new business, commissioners?
None at all, Larry.
We have a temporary appropriation for Kennet Public Schools.
Have a temporary appropriation for public schools. Make a motion to approve the temporary appropriation on public schools.
Second.
Joe Clement.
Yes.
Jerry Terrell.
Yes.
Stoney Oaken.
Yes.
Okay, moving on to item six, approve commissioners proceeding for previous meeting.
Make a motion to approve.
I'll second.
Art McLeary.
Yes.
Larry Watson.
Yes.
Billy Cloud.
Yes.
Item number seven.
They need to initial.
Oh.
Make a motion to approve the previous minutes of the Exeter Commissioners meeting.
I second.
Joe Clement.
Yes.
Jerry Terrell.
Yes.
Stoney Oaken.
Yes. Okay, item number seven, approve blanket PO. Do you have any blanket? No action needed on seven today. Item number eight, discuss and consider taking possible action on approving authority having jurisdiction AHJ with Theresa Darnby from Regional Development Solutions.
Hi, good morning. How are you guys doing?
Good.
My name is Larissa, and I'm with Regional Development Solutions, and I'm here to discuss the possibility of you guys taking AHJ, which stands for Authority Having Jurisdiction, from the State Fire Marshal's Office for you guys to be able to do your own building inspections, to issue certificates of occupancies through your locality, as opposed to sending your citizens through the state process. I brought some materials for you guys to kind of reference. Right now, as it stands, your county does not do building inspections for the businesses within your locality, which has been pretty standard in Oklahoma, at least for my whole career. I've got 21 years of experience. My background is I was a city planner and a community development director for cities around Tulsa, Jinx, Owosso, and Catoosa. And up until this year, I think that most of the state has operated under the ideology that if you're in a rural area or outside of the city limits that exercise authority having jurisdiction, that there were no codes. this year, the State Fire Marshal's Office has stated that that's never been the case, that there have always been codes, and they have amended their enforcement of those codes. In addition to that, previously to this year, they were only doing inspections on things like schools, hospitals, churches, convention centers, things where you would have a large population of people that would have a difficulty being able to exit a building in the situation of a fire, which makes sense. So apartment buildings over 4 units or more, things of that nature. At this point, they are enforcing it on any commercial business. The first wave of businesses that has brought all of this to light, of course, is the medical marijuana industry, because they're required to have certificates of occupancy now to meet the OBNDD and OMA requirements, which is pretty standard. So more urban areas would require that from the beginning, so now we're kind of chasing our tails, or we're going back and having people go through this process. The issue with that is that the State Fire Marshal's Office traditionally sees about 2,000 building permits per year. This year, they'll see about 36,000. They have not been able to scale to meet the demands. And we're looking, so generally on a year where you don't have this many permits, you're looking at about a year to 18 months to get through that process entirely, which is pretty inefficient. In the localities I worked in, you could get an inspection, basically, if you called it in before one, you'd get it the same day or the next day if it was after one. Permit review, depending on the complexity of it, anywhere from 48 hours to, you know, maybe 2 weeks. So you're talking about major gaps in time. Stigler, the city of Stigler, did take HJ in the last few months. I know that there was some issues there when the Taco Bell was coming into town, too. These are things that happen to businesses of any type and variety, not just medical marijuana. And again, they are going to be enforcing this on all businesses. I don't believe that they're going to go retroactively backwards per se, but they are saying that if you are going to be going into a new business is going up, then they will be requiring it, and they will shut them down if they don't. A little bit of background on AHJ. The localities have the inherent right to jurisdict over these matters. It's been set up that way in the country. And in our own state statutes, it states, you know, that if a city, town, or county doesn't exercise those rights, then the state assumes it. The bigger question at that point is now, too, what happens when you assumed it? Because a lot of people weren't made aware that this was happening. So a lot of counties and localities, when people would call to ask about it, they'd say, oh, you're out in the county, you don't have codes, or we don't have codes here. So obviously not the case. What I've done is, in conjunction with Oki Safety, we have created a system where counties would be able to adopt AHJ without having the major issues that you would typically acquire whenever you do something like that. So we take care of everything from, you would have like a web page that could be embedded into your website if you already have one. That would be for a development services section, and it would talk about when you would need a permit, when you wouldn't, and then it would have a portal link where you could submit your building permit applications. Those would go directly to Oki Safety. They would do the plan review. Once the plans were approved, then they can schedule the inspection. Once the inspections were had and those inspections were passed, you guys would get notification. And generally in other counties, what happens is so every week, whenever you guys have your commissioners meeting, you would get a list and say these, you know, permits were approved, and you would just sign off on the certificates of occupancies at that point. So big concerns that have been raised at other county meetings have been issues of liability, who's going to handle the workload for this, things like that. And those documents that I gave you kind of give you some overline of that. As far as liability, so my company and their company does hold errors and omissions and liability insurance. So if there were an issue, then it would be covered on our insurance. A lot of questions come up too, you know, if somebody has a fire and somebody gets hurt in it, are we liable? First and foremost, it's very, very rare that you have a fire where you're not going to have a fire in general. I can think of one time where it was questionable in 20 years. Because of a faulty inspection. Generally, your fires are going to be from somebody plugged something in, had an extension cord, a device malfunctioned, or you have arson. So that is over 99% of what happens on that. As far as the workload, you know, we would want to have as much information on that website as easily digestible as possible, but there's also a phone number that people could call to ask questions about the plan review process. I think at this point I'm going to see if you like what your specific questions would be, or if you guys have any, and then I can kind of pivot to your specific criteria and questions.
I just want the county to be held harmless, you know, if anything happens. I mean, you're assuming the liability, that's the main thing.
Right.
I don't want to come back on the taxpayers.
Yep.
Well, what is the limit of your liability?
There's a $6 million. I think mine's $2 million.
So you'll come in and you'll do the fire marshal inspection as a third party and report to the state fire marshal, and everything will be within compliance.
Yeah, so we'll teach you guys, you'll have your policies. I can help you guys write your resolutions, your policies, your procedures, your handbooks. Generally, we would advise you just to adopt the state minimum requirements, but as time goes on, if you guys wanted to go over that, you absolutely have the right to do that, but we do have to adopt the state minimums by the OUBCC. Oki Safety will come in and do the inspections. Shauna had brought up a question previously about if, I guess you guys have some concerns about the businesses in general, and I would recommend that you guys, if you wanted to, would have a business license or something along those lines that was annual for you guys, somebody in your office to go out and do an inspection if you wanted to. It's not a requirement by any means, but if that is a concern, then that is something that we can also, you know, help you tailor some policies. It would give you guys a little bit of income, but I guess the assessor's office has some concerns about some of those businesses too.
Is there a fee to the county or to the business?
Yeah, how are you funded? Do you bill on the inspection to the business owner?
Yeah, so we would, the citizens who are applying for the building permits would pay for that. Oki Safety charges the same amount as the state fire marshal's office does, which is going to go up soon, but right now it is 10 cents a square foot plus a $4 OUBCC fee. Their minimum is higher than the state's, so their minimum is 300 as opposed to 50. So anything that would be less than 3,000 square feet would spend a little bit more money, but you're talking about a 7 to 14 day turnaround time on a plan review and 7 to 14 day turnaround time on a building permit, as opposed to, we're looking at over 2 years at this point.
Is that information in this packet?
Yes, sir.
The numbers?
I don't know if the fee schedule's on there, but I can send one over. On top of that, generally we would encourage you guys to add something for the county to be able to handle, just in case you guys did have something that comes up, because that is a very low fee anyways. I mean, Muskogee charges 50 cents a square foot. I don't know that I would charge that much, but there's definitely room in there for you guys to make a little bit of profit too. And then also there would be my administrative fee for my company for the website and all of that, which is, I think it's like $100 a permit that would come in.
Is all that a one-time fee or is that a yearly fee?
It's just a one-time for the applicant, so whatever permit comes through. But yeah, you guys, if you wanted to be the ones that took in the money, you could, but we can also do it where they take it in, and then you guys, if you wanted to add in fees on top of it, you guys would get your check every month with a report, which you're going to get a report anyways every month, but whether or not you guys add on fees, that's up to you guys.
It looks like it'd get these guys rolling, get them making money, get them in compliance quick. I mean, that's the direction we need to head.
Yeah.
It would be helpful for the assessor's office as well, because we have some major safety concerns when we go to inspect some of the businesses, where we're not welcome there once they're already in business. So it would be very helpful for us to be able to assess the property before they're even in there working, and then we're not a bother to them, and it would definitely benefit us and the, like you said, the applicants. It would really benefit them because I've met with these visitors many times over a period of months. Can you tell us how long you've been waiting on your certificate?
We've been waiting for like almost a year.
Yeah. And no answer from the fire marshal's office as to when they may even get that. So.
Well, if we were to act on this today, how long would it take you to get fired up?
So if you guys wanted to move forward on it today, then we would have you send an email and a letter into the state fire marshal's office stating that you guys are going to be taking your AHJ. They'll send back a form, and you'll fill that form out and send it back. It's about 30 days from that point, but that gives us time to come in, you know, talk with your office. I don't know if it'd be the assessor or whomever runs your website. And if you guys want us to embed your website in there, we would do that and just get the system.
We don't have one.
Okay, so then we would just
Okay.
So we would just set one up for you guys, and it would be Haskell County Development Services, something along those lines. You guys would need to decide like what you want your URL to be, or we could just do it off the company and just link it that way, whatever you guys prefer. And these things can all change. You guys have absolute authority and autonomy to be able to make decisions like this. Obviously, on the front end, we don't know what you guys are going to experience, because each locality is truly unique as far as what kind of businesses and things are there. But yeah, so at the front end, probably just set up a typical website for you guys and get it going. So, you know, we would be ready by the time they granted that authority to you guys.
Somebody's got to monitor that, though, if you set that website up. Somebody's...
You have to have an administrator.
Well, if we link it through your company, then
yeah,
it won't be a standalone, right?
No, it wouldn't at that point.
Is that something you think would work, Sean?
As far as I know, it's worth a
go.
It's got
to take a load off your office.
Yes. It would be helpful for us. It would just make the load safer and quicker and more efficient. And for the taxpayers as well.
Yeah.
I think it would give you guys some clarity. I think what I've noticed in the last year is that there's a really big issue with the communication between government agencies at different levels. That's been a little bit disheartening. So, you know, I've heard it wasn't Stigler, it was Stillwell, that they were calling the fire marshal's office. They had an Atwoods going in that was going to be larger than 12,000 square feet, and that's kind of a threshold in the ICC when you start getting into a little bit more particular codes, and they couldn't get an answer. So just having clarity, I think, and having resources available to you guys to pick up a call and just get an answer and resources, you know, to say, hey, well, here's the statute on that, or here's the code on this, just would make you guys feel better, too.
Well, before we've had that little form, the zoning form, and then we send it in, and I think those are getting kicked back now.
Oh, the COC?
Yeah.
The COCs, so that, again, as somebody that's been doing this for 21 years, that document was a little bit, it wasn't frustrating to me, but it made no sense. It has a total mishmash of issues on it. It was written by, you know, and I think at this point we're 5 years in, almost 6 years in. The OMA's got a really nice way of redefining terms that they don't have the authority to define, that are already defined by, like, contract employees, an example, or what's an indoor versus an outdoor. Well, the ICC gets to set that, not you. And so it just caused a lot of issues. But yeah, the COC won't suffice as far as keeping them compliant at this point.
Well, at this point, I think we need to go forward. I mean, we still got some steps on our end to get, you know, the form back and fill it out.
So,
right now, I think we need to go forward with it. That's just my opinion.
So if you guys wanted to vote to take that, then I can write an email for Shauna for you guys to send over to the office. And then I would encourage you to send a, you know, physical letter as well, and then they'll get that form back to you, and then I can put you guys together the next steps and get scheduled with you guys to come in and show you guys, you know, this is what we'll be operating off of, and see if you guys want to change it or amend it in any way.
And then at that point, would we decide whether or not to charge a fee and how much? Or?
We would decide before you guys actually adopt it, so sometime within that, before that 30 days is up. And I'll give you some examples of some neighboring areas and what they charge. Because again, it's a large gap, and their fees are extremely low with the state. And every client that I have and every person that owns a business that I know of is willing to pay, you know, a little bit more. One, it's better for the community. You guys now are aware of each other, and we're not acting like we don't like each other, is what I found. You know, a lot of these meetings, you have people that have never come into a commissioner meeting. It kind of takes a little bit of the mysteriousness out of it, I guess, to put it lightly. It also is nice because obviously there are bad actors, and if the state's intent is to catch bad actors, they're not going through these processes. It's going to make them stand out even more. Another thing that's come up that is with the sheriff's office. I guess OMA and the OBN doesn't like giving the sheriff's office a lot of information on these because they want to handle all control and authority on investigations, which kind of ties you guys' hands in this situation of safety and that's kind of a big issue. So now if you have active building permits, because you guys are going to get reports every month, and then you'll get an annual report, like these are the addresses, the permits, this is the use, square footage, all of those things. You'll get enough, there'll be a number, because you have to put how much the job costs, so you'll have an idea of like, hey, we did, you know, $30 million of construction work on these building permits this year. Gives you guys a little bit more data and stuff. But the sheriffs really like it, because at that point, you know, then you have these building permits. And if you have a business license, it really helps. And there are a lot of counties and cities and towns that do have a business license. Because after that COO is issued, you don't have to do it again unless you change the business or change the use or an owner. So you could go years without seeing anybody. So a business license is a good idea if you do have true concerns on that. But we would just want, I would encourage, you know, like, hey, maybe have this policy where if you have building permits issued, it automatically goes to the sheriff's office, and we just show that chain of custody so that somebody doesn't, you know, just in reading the statutes, you know, the state statutes for counties as opposed to cities and municipalities, they're so much more open-ended on the county side, which is why I think that we see, you know, in some parts of states, county commissioners maybe getting in trouble for things that generally wouldn't be something to get somebody in trouble for, but they didn't have a policy. And because you guys are elected in, nobody really gets a ton of time in those roles generally. And so just having clear policies in place, I think, is a really great protective instrument for you guys, too.
And that'll make a difference as to you'll have to set up a fund. So like you're talking about, you'll have to have a building department. Because as the county, we cannot make a profit.
Right.
We are not in the county is not in the business to make a profit. We offer a service. And that is what the statute says. So places that do, it's because they have specific building planning commissions. They have a building committee. Because you have to be real careful how you set this up.
So it would go into a fund. Most of the counties don't have planning commissions. But I mean, yeah, obviously you have to have a balanced budget, of course. So whether you guys, it's hard to say where your money's going to go that you guys take in, you know, once we start looking at numbers, then you guys, maybe you decide, honestly, what happens a lot of times is you guys decide to end up making that an internal department. And so there's, you know, vehicles and things like that, but it's kind of nice on the county side, I think, especially for you guys to kind of get familiarized with the process and the terminology. And if somebody's like inherently interested in that in the assessor's office or something like that, then, you know, maybe they go through those trainings to be able to do those inspections themselves, and so it could cover those things.
Have you worked with ACCO much?
ACCO?
ACCO, Association of County Commissioners.
I have not worked with the ACCO at all. I mostly do COGS and localities and the OML.
I'm just wondering, because I would like to back up and run this through them just to make sure. And are you guys the only ones? Do you have competing companies?
I wish. Yeah, I didn't really have time to create this, and I kind of went through the process over the last 9 months in a few other places. No, there isn't competition for this because the money isn't very good in it, for at least for me. It would take a long time for me to recoup my cost on it. Okie Safety, Okie Safety is the largest one in the state for those type of services. There are two other guys that offer the same service, but they're standalone guys. I don't know about their insurance, and they just, in my opinion, I trust Okie Safety because they teach a lot of the classes that the fire marshals have to take. They've been doing it for a long time. I know that they have 9 unlimited building inspectors. So I'm just more comfortable with them and their insurance policies and their procedures, and they do have a formal office set up. So, but there are two other guys that do it in the state.
I'd kind of like to take a week and take this over and study it out a little bit.
Run it through ACCO and get their opinion on it.
Come back, maybe I'll just be a bar or something.
I have ran it through the Department of Commerce, and they liked it, so. But I'm happy to come back and meet with you guys, you know, one-on-one. I know it's like a big issue. I hate to take up so much time in meetings because you guys have several things you need to do.
No, this is a big deal. We need to get past it. I mean, we need to figure out what we're going to do going forward.
Yeah, I'm happy to work with you guys in any way to help you achieve that and keep it moving forward.
Are you in other counties? Any neighboring counties?
So I was working with ADARE for about 9 months. They had originally voted for it, and then at the last meeting they voted against it. I was kind of surprised by that because there weren't reasons presented. But also I kind of understand because they went through that process through 9 months, so we're kind of, this is something that I've done with a lot of cities and towns, counties. It's not something we ever go through for counties because this has never been an issue. Also understanding the goals and objectives of a county versus a city is different, and then also your statutes are totally different. But Charles Beecher over there, he was fantastic to work with. If you guys want to talk with him, just the ADA that kind of stepped in, I guess, had some very personal opinions on the industry and things like that. But, and I know this is a recording, it was a lot of rhetoric. There was nothing, you know, the 3 points he brought up were incorrect, and we proved that in the meeting. But Pawnee County's taking it, Nevada's in the contract portion. Okie Safety also does Tulsa County's inspections and Oklahoma County's inspections, and then about, you know, 70 different cities, towns, and college campuses and tribes across the state.
I'm going to make a motion that we table it for a week and do some research on it.
Second.
Mark McLary?
Yes.
Larry Watson?
Yes.
Billy Cloud?
Yes.
Thank you.
My pleasure. Thank you, guys.
Item number 9, discuss and consider Haskins County District 3 going out for bids on a used tractor with side boot mower.
Make a motion to approve.
I'll second it.
Mark McLary?
Yes.
Larry Watson?
Yes.
Billy Cloud?
Yes.
Exercise Board, number 5, review and sign and approve appropriations and transfers of appropriations.
Make a motion to approve.
I second.
Joe Clement?
Yes.
Stoney Odom?
Yes.
Jerry Carroll?
Item number 10, review and sign and approve appropriations, transfer appropriations, check received, bills, due time.
Second.
Mark McLary?
Yes.
Larry Watson?
Yes.
Billy Cloud?
Yes.
know exactly how, but that will have to be kind of segregated because, again, the county isn't in the business to make money. That's why usually it's like a city issue because the city can't, they have leeway that the county doesn't have. But you can ask ACCO, but if what she's talking about, just going with what their base amount is and not upcharging, you may be fine. But
just be a wash. I mean, that's what we need to do.
Yes, that, and that I think you would be okay doing something like that for the sake of the assessor's office. The other part I don't know is kind of how she talked. Are they just a facilitator and then you will have
using,
to have...
They're using Oki, right?
Yes.
She's got $2 million and they've got $6 million, so we've got $8 million worth of coverage.
Yeah, but if they're just a facilitator, you might talk to ACCO about that.
Yeah, we'll call Adair County.
Now, is this just all new businesses?
She said she didn't know if that retroactive or not, so they could go back. If I understood that right.
Yeah, that's what she said.
So has the county got to furnish their own inspector and office to manage all this?
I thought they was doing
it. She said that they would do it.
She said she'd set it up for the county. The county had to have their inspectors and office to.
Yeah. I'm thinking she's more a facilitator. Isn't that kind of what you thought?
I assume, the way I understood it, that they would come and train whoever you wanted. That's the way I understood it, that the county would provide the person to get the training to do the inspections.
Yeah.
So then the county is going to be out of money.
Yeah, it's going to be on the assessor's office.
That was the way I understood it, but I could be wrong.
That's kind of how I understood what she was saying.
Well, that's why we need to have a meeting with this term. You know what I mean? A special meeting, so we could get to the ins and outs of a lot of things. There's a lot of questions there. But...
Talk to one of these other counties that's used her.
I don't know if she ever said any other county was using it. Mm-hmm.
I don't think so.
When that question was asked, she didn't name one county that was using it.
Well, she didn't name Pawnee.
I thought she said she named Pawnee. There was only one, though.
Yeah.
Well, she said something about Tulsa County.
Yeah, she said say Tulsa County.
But Tulsa and Oklahoma County have a different set of rules than everybody else. Yeah. So they have a different, they're completely.
Contact Adair County and see why they dropped
it.
There's no world too.
They are.
Well, it seems to me like you have to have more payroll than another office set up for somebody full time.
And then you could have charge to cover the cost, but then you have to factor if you're going to get enough income to cover the cost of the employee, the inspector, the training. And I'll be honest, I've had COS. I'm certified COS, and it's hard. It is. It's difficult. And I did mine in St. Louis with HUD, and it's not an easy class. It's several weeks and difficult.
Too much stuff to do today to create a table. Questions? Yeah. Gotta have time for Joe to figure that out.
I'm just trying to keep break even on the deal, you know?
Talking pretty fast.
discount it to 250, pay the audit.
They got a good job. Just picked his deductible. Go pay.
Do you want to get a hold of Chris or Dale or anything?
I'll call Sam.
That's what I was going to call Larry Woods and see if one of us needs to talk to one of the commissioners.
Say they went from 2,000 to 30-something thousand?
That's what I thought you said.
Yep.
The 36.
That's a huge backlog.
Yeah.
We charge Garden Cemetery, they were wanting some pretty good price on it.
Garden Cemetery?
They want a couple, and they brought that up decoration Saturday.
It's cost about $100 for material, and we're not charging anything like that, but I did find out that we can take money out of our donation account, purchase the material, trustees can build them, we can sell them, whatever, and put it back into our donation account.
talking about material, put a little on it.
Yeah. But as far as something like that, you know, just modified material.
Miss Mark, she was. Let's see about it. I know I talked to him.
Terry, before you leave, can you run by my office? Caitlin had tried to call last week. We have all of our resale properties, I think, ready for service.
Okay.
So I think she's got them all ready to go.
Okay. Do you guys have any idea what the procedure might be for county to adopt some ordinances or something for the county, like for trash or people not mowing their yards and stuff that are on the road, highway? Okay. Is there anything we can do to enforce that?
I'm sure it can be done.
Yeah, we do have set up like a mowing lien and a trash lien that can run through just like any other tax load that can be, and it's attached to their.
Yeah, but I don't think we don't have an ordinance for that.
We don't want.
That's what I'm trying to see how we can get one in place. I know the cities, the municipalities have it. And DEQ has some stuff that is getting them out to do anything. Like some of these marijuana farms, they just pile trash up. Like Stoney's got a real problem right next to him. Trash everywhere.
I got bought that. He's been eating a bunch of stuff this weekend. And you're a brush hogging farm. So I think he'll take care of it. He said he's going to try to get everything picked up. Still, it's all over.
There was a bunch of trash everywhere. I don't know how you didn't end up with it all over you.
We had some. Those trees caught a bunch of it.
Right.
Well, we had some.
And then we've got some of these people that moved in that built them. They don't maintain their yards. They don't mow them. There's grass 3 feet high in their yards.
Yeah. That seems to be pretty common.
Yeah. And I've had several people complain to me, but I don't know what we can do about it yet.
So are you talking about just four marijuana farms?
No, anybody. Okay. We couldn't
wow.
Make it for all of them.
I
was that we stopped with?
Just list if anything stands out.
I haven't had a chance to.
You don't talk to Sam at Adair County?
I will, yeah.
I'll try to get a hold of Larry Woods.
Charge an extra fee just to cover the cost of it, but
well, that's, you don't know if you'd ever break even on the deal, whether it'd be worth a couple years ago we could have stabbed a couple folks probably.
Fee, it's not going to offset the cost of having another employee.
Okay, moving on to item number 11 to adjourn.
Make a motion to adjourn.
Second.
Hart and Flaherty?
Yes.
Larry Watson?
Yes.
Billy Cloud?
Yes.